Moses. Deuteronomy chapter number 2, verses 1 to 3. Wandering in the desert, when we turn back and set out toward the wilderness, along the route to the Red Sea, and the Lord have directed me, for a long time we made our way around the hill country of Seir. For long time, you have gone around this situation for too long. You have postponed your education for too long. You have postponed your business to too long. You have postponed this particular exams that you felt that you cannot pass. You have postponed it for too long. The Bible said, they turn around and go around those mountains for too long. What have kept you from trusting God? When the Lord told me to serve this foundation, to build this school military ministry center, when he drew the plans to me, and it was too huge. At a time when we were flooring, doing the floors, you know, we bought so many iron rods, cement, everything. It's like money is pumping in every day, in day out. Sometimes I feel like it is too big. But anything that is not bigger than you is not from God, because every dream that you dreamt must be so big that put fear in you. God, this is how God operates. So I want you to understand that. Don't wait for somebody to tell you that there's something unique about you. You have a special gift and ability to do exceedingly above. All what God is doing from you is waiting for a child of God to make a step to the God who follow you and push you to that promise. All what he needs is that. If you stand still, if you stay, God cannot do nothing. God not operate in a vacuum. He operates in you. God cannot do exceedingly above without you. All what he needs is that, my son, my daughter, arise as a champion and let me push you into that vision, into that dream. He said, this one, you have been going around this mountain. Mountain of barrenness. Mountain of poverty. Mountain of singleness, mountain of sickness, mountain of disgrace, mountain of setback, mountain of non-achievement and non-progress. You have gone around too long. Time has come for you to push forward. When you push forward, the God who can do exceedingly above, more than you think or ask, he'll show himself up. This God is a wonderful God. He's a marvelous God that if you can believe in him, he's able to do whatever promise he has promised you. I was in that side one day, the general superintendent of Ghana Assemblies of God came to that place to visit. He looked at it. I took him to the hall. We have classroom there. The school of ministry can have almost 200 students. We have dormitories that hosted over 300 people can come there and stay. There's a sanctuary inside that seats over 1,000. We have executive VIP rooms where somebody like you go to Ghana and you say, I love it. We have 35 rooms, like hotel rooms. And you look at all the places, you look, this man, how did you draw this vision? How did you? I said, Mama, it's not me. I felt that I want to challenge God. Though he's so big to be challenged, but I just want to test his faith. Because God is a faithful. If it is faith, you need to test the faith. Somebody said, oh, can you test God's faith? Yes. Abraham tested the faith of God. Because God, the Bible said, in faith, he created all things. Remember the book of Hebrews. It's not happening. He said, well, everybody's fine. Did I say something out of usual? No. This is the faith of God. Because his promises are his words. And his words are his faith. Whatever he said, he will do it. He said, in Hebrews chapter 11, verse it has become a history. Some people have even started cooking. They said that we don't need the plastic. We are already coming to say that as long as there's a roof on it, prayer is going to start. I said, you can't, no child, free. Hallelujah. Because the people look at the mountain as a challenge to them. Verse 2, he said to me, you have made your way around the street. You have made your way around this hill country. Not enough. Not enough, brothers and sisters. What are the some of the places that have been staying for long enough? What are the things that you feel afraid to move forward? Face the thing that will afraid you. Face them. The thing that you are afraid, they are afraid you. But if you don't make a step of faith, you will never see the exceeding and abundant power of God. He's able to do it. Just make a faith statement. Move a step and trust in this God. He will not disappoint you. He will not fail you. So I wanted to know that because they were in a wilderness. Wilderness is a place of no hope. Wilderness is a place where plans have been destroyed. Wilderness is a place of setback and progressions. What is your wilderness? A place where you feel so sad, so pain, so much rejected. It's a place where you feel that there's no hope in your life. In your wilderness is a place of pain. It's a place where you cry every day in your bedroom. It's a place that you know there's no hope for them tomorrow. They were there for 40 years, and the Lord said, time has come for you to leave that wilderness and go to the promised land, a place where I've set it for you, a place where there's honey and milk over there waiting for you. But if you don't move forward, you stand still. Hallelujah. In the desert, Bible said many of the men were wasted. Because in your desert period, if you don't trust God to overcome that challenge, you're going to be wasted. Your destiny will be useless. Many people could not fulfill their destiny, not because of a wish, but because of their inability to trust God. Their inability to believe in this God and His way that is able to do exceedingly above more than what we ask or think. In your desert, be careful. They circle around the mountain and their life could not come to pass. They wasted their destiny. They couldn't move forward. You know, even in water, there's a proverb in Ghana that they said that if water is stayed in one place, it begins to stink. That's why water must be floating. It must be moving. If you keep the water in a barrel for couple of months or years without using it, it changes its taste. It changes whatever in it. And it's not used for anything. That's how life is. If you don't move forward in life and become stagnant and stay in one place, circle around, your life becomes wasted. And many Christians' lives have become wasted. They're not praying, but they're standing still. There's something in you that you must do. No matter the challenges, no matter the falling, no matter how struggling it is, yes, it's part of it. Because the work you found means that there's a hope for you to move forward tomorrow. So Bible said they were standing still. They could not move forward. Feel the challenge of life and see that God will help you to move forward. If you don't face these challenges, you're never excited. Knowing the purpose leads to fulfillment of life and joy and peace. You must know the purpose and system. When you're going from above a mountain, it takes away your job. Because there's a destination ahead of you. The Israelites knew that around the mountains is not a place for them. They knew that they need to move forward because there's a destination and a promise of God to their forefathers that they are going to the land of Canaan, a land where honey and milk is there. So when they were hanging around, Moses and other leaders didn't like him. Where is your destination? You know where you are going. Nobody can change your plan. But if you don't know where you are going, everybody can tell you where to go, and you are certain. If you don't know what you want in life, people can tell you what you want, and you are certain. People will tell you that nurse is true, and you also want to be a nurse. People will tell you that today is a truck driver, and you really want to be a truck driver. I know somebody who has done all, you have gone to the school of driving, and bought a driving school. I wonder why it is. As long as I'm driving and school all together, it's fine. Hallelujah. But still, couldn't fulfill it. Why? Because you don't know what is wrong in life. Life is not about people. You know that you are not a photocopy, you are original. You know that every time that's what you are. Government documents, document they have said, I don't copy it. Why? Because they want to see the original. So you, as a child of God, you have a destination. There's a place where you settle, you become happy. There's a place where you know you reach that, you know that you fulfill destiny. But when you have a man around the same mountains, and your life becomes standstill, it takes away your joy and your happiness. So knowing purpose leads to fulfillment of life. You need to fulfill life. But this God is there to help you. I want you to know that. When you make a step, you will do that thing that will blow your mind. I've tested this God for a few times and you never fail me. Church, I encourage you, in this country, they said America is the country of opportunities. So many opportunities are here. Anything that you can do can bring you money. Some people started it. Recently I saw something in eating condition. And now the guy who can eat those hamburgers is a billionaire now. Hot dogs. And the guy eats 100 pieces within 5 minutes. And he's a champion of hot dog. And he's a millionaire. Now advertising for hot dog. And making millions of dollars. At least if you eat that and your stomach becomes okay, be approving. But at least you are making money. But don't eat all the fufu and make your stomach big without making money. It's a useless of the former. Hallelujah, somebody. So, you know, there's a purpose in your life. Your purpose is finding your lane in life and driving hard on it. Your purpose is to find your lane. What is your lane? What is your purpose? Why are you at home? You know, if you are doing anything outside your calling, you don't feel fulfilled. If you are doing anything outside your calling, God, every one of you, remember what time I told you that when a child is born, they announce their presence, they are not crying. If you go to a hospital, you are a nurse or a doctor, you know, every child born, immediately they come from the womb. First thing they know they do, they cry. If they don't cry, the nurses will beat them to cry. But they don't beat them, they hit their back, blah, 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 and they're teaching them. Almost still home. You know, teaching is. The child must cry. Because, tell me, you know that. If the child didn't cry, what happened? They will make sure he cried or she cried. If not, they need to send him or her to spend. Because you must cry. And they are not crying because they are crying, no. They are making their announcement that I am here as a CEO. course of life and be in it, focusing, pray towards it, conduct it. Because many Christians are shifting from their purpose. And then they lose it. God has a particular, you know, the reason why God asked Adam, where are you? He didn't, God is not, God don't know where Adam is standing. But God was asking Adam, why have you shifted from the place of creation? Why have you shifted, Adam, from the purpose I have for you? You move to the other side that will destroy your life. Brothers and sisters, there's a place God has set in you. That's why I want you to understand that this God who can do exceedingly above what you can ask and think, have the plans and purpose for you. Don't shift it into other lane. Don't move. Don't follow the crowd. Sometimes you need to stand alone. You need to stand alone. When everybody was saying that you won't make it, stand alone and try this God. I've told you this story many times when me and mommy went to a senior pastor and told him and the wife that God had called us to move to Columbus, Ohio to plant the church. My pastor's wife, who had been saved for 3 years, look at me and said, Miss Mommy, you know that you're illiterate. In America, illiterates cannot plant church. You've never been to Bible school, you've never been a pastor, not even a deacon before. It was a very big blow to me. And I thank God for the wise woman that God gave her to me. She looked at me and said, don't mind them, God speak to you. God speak to you. The follow that God who speak to you. And time will come. When you are faithful to the key, English will come. Remember the story. And today, the God who speak English are better in me. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So be in your lane. Because God who do a similar about what now as the Bible says, he is a God that darkness and light is not in him. He don't swear, he don't move, he stands on his word. But the word that he has given to you, he's faithful to fulfill it. Be not afraid when he delay. Have some friends who told me some years back, man, you cannot be a pastor or cannot listen. But today they come to me and begging me to be part of their life. They stole the goodness through away. One day, the God who do exceedingly and above will take that stone and become a goodness stone. I want to challenge you, brothers and sisters. Don't look at your present condition and make a decision for your future. Because your future is in the hands of God who can do exceedingly and above what you can think or ask. He never fails. He will do it. He can use an electric like me, a social boy, a village boy, to do this in this world. Today when I go to Ghana, they treat me like a king. Why? Because this 13 years, 14 years ago, nobody considered me anybody. Even in my family, if my name is mentioned, then they say, wahala, something I've lost. But today, this exceedingly God, who can do more than you can do. I just want to encourage you. Stop going around that mountain and move forward. Because there's glory waiting upon you. There's grace waiting upon you. There's favor waiting upon you. There's goodness waiting upon you. As long as you are going through that mountain, they are still waiting for you. But today, you move forward. They will embrace you and say, welcome. We have been waiting for you for too long. This God of Israel, the one who do exceedingly above, and you can see what you can do in your life. Just be on your feet, because this God is telling you something. You have been going around that mountain for too long. Time has come to leave some people behind, leave those friends behind, leave those chickens behind. The chicken people are people who always talk, but hang around with eagles. So there's eagle in you. There's something unusual about your life. The Lord is waiting. Grace is waiting. Favor is waiting. Money is waiting. Goodness is waiting. All you want is that move forward and the grace of God that make God do the seemingly and the power about what you take shall empower you. Empower you for success. Yes. Empower.
Let's pray. Those online, please give and support.
global life and give it, and God wants to bless you. Let's pray. Father, we come with a substance in our hand. We give our tithe and offering to support your work. Bless your people as they give. The Bible says, give and it shall be given back to us. The same that shall run it over shed together. Your people have been obeyed, and obedience is better than sacrifice. By the obedience, let them eat the fruit of the land. Protect us from the devourer, against our job, against our health, against our children. This week, our going out and coming in be a blessing. Protect us from the evil. I plead the blood of Jesus against every weapon of the enemy. Every member of this church, we ask you, God, for your protection. Wherever they go, those who have traveled, let your hand be over us. May God bless you. May the Lord shine his face towards you. May goodness of the Lord be upon you. May you be covered from accident and the works of the enemy. We give you praise for what you have done in Jesus' name. Amen. Before we give our offering, our guest is our patient.